But we managed to repair most of the superficial damage, and we didn't take any casualties, which is the main thing when it comes to surviving within a colony. If one of your colonists becomes incapacitated, that can more or less be a death sentence if it's the only one that has a particular skill. However, we're doing okay at the moment. But I don't want to count my chickens before they are hatched, because this game can sometimes be a bit of a dick and throw whatever the hell it wants at you whenever it wants. Such as sometimes you'll get a raid during a solar flare, which I've had in the past, along with a ship part, which doesn't tend to happen on this kind of mode, but it tends to happen on Randy Random quite a bit. Okay, so we're going to fast forward a little bit until my colonists decide to wake up, which they have done now. So they're going to start mining out all this. Doc's going to do his usual cleaning thing, which is good. Usually you don't have a colonist who has nothing to do, so they don't really clean that much. That's like the least priority for a colonist. Oh, he's even cleaning outside. That's good of him. Okie dokie. So we're right now trying to uncover this area here, and once that's been done, actually I need to place, have I got a dump ground yet? No, I don't. No wonder not. Oh, I do. Why hasn't this been hauled then? That's strange. We're currently trying to clear out this area. It's been slowed down slightly by this plasteel. I don't tend to use plasteel much, but it's quite strong. It's stronger than steel, and it can be used for just about everything. You use it for doors, you can use it for turrets if you so choose to do so. I'm actually going to move these turrets. Hopefully it won't leave me too open for a bit, but I realised after recording that I could have avoided that fire that nearly destroyed my colony just by not having the turrets right next to the damn base and having them in the corner here. Yes, they risk hitting my power supply, but it's kind of a better trade-off than losing the entire base to an imminent shot from a caterpillar, which is what more or less happened, and I was saved by the rain of all things. So I'm going to go ahead and place a turret here. Yeah, he'll probably set fire to the dumping ground outside, but I don't particularly care about that at this stage. So they're going to go ahead and deconstruct that. Where are you going? You are going to go get some more metal. Alrighty then. So the reason why it seems a little bit easy at the moment is I did pick the rough mode rather than the challenge mode, which as far as I can remember, all the threats are 70% the size of in challenge mode or something like that. It's not too easy. The colony that I've actually managed to get quite far on is on the same difficulty, and I'm at the stage now where I'm getting mechs all the time. Yay! Didn't expect that. Okay, let's do mortars now. They are very important for if you begin to be shelled, you can return fire from the safety of your base while you get bombarded. The only risk I have really is this area here. I don't think this area is covered by a hard mountain as far as I can remember. So any errant shells that come in, any incendiaries, will most likely set fire to that room. So I'm going to maybe looking to move in the main sleeping area into here once it's been completed. So what I'll do is, just to be on the safe side, I'll create a wall here, a steel auto door here, and I will also lay the first power cables, like so. And I don't know if redundancy really counts in this. I do sometimes use redundancy, say, if an explosion takes out a little bit of the conduits, you have the redundancy to keep power. But it also costs more in the long run, because you're laying down more cables. But I think it saved me slightly when I was under attack earlier. Now, I've been recording this over several days, so I can't always remember what my train of thought was in the video before. So sorry if I'm rehashing a lot of the stuff. One has to sleep, so I don't have the time to play constantly. I wish I did. But no, real life calls. And I really wish Doc, with all his cleaning skills, could actually haul. Can he? No. You're a brawler, so... Oh, That's why. It's not actually a hauler by trade. Okay. No wonder he was cleaning all the time. He wasn't actually told to do anything else. But it's not too bad. At least we don't have a blood-splattered floor, which tends to happen. Because cleaning is the least priority if you... Those are boom rats, aren't they? Oh, God, that's going to be fun. But I don't want to hunt that tortoise, because tortoise are a bitch to take down. There we go. What was I even saying? I've totally lost my train of thought. I just talk and talk and talk and talk. And just hope that the game doesn't decide to be an utter dick. Let's find out the rest of this. Bomb, bomb. Oh yes, real life calls sometimes. I do like to play games like as many parts as I can. But sometimes I just run out of time. So things take several days. A good ship is nearby. Very good. What is a good ship doing? They are an exotic gun transporter. Let's see what they have. I don't usually bother with these, but I might as well. Call the exotic good people. Okay, so they've got limestone. Okay, they've got a masterwork slate sculpture, personnel core, a power claw, a social neuro trainer. That could be nice, but I'm not interested, sorry. I tend to like to harvest all I can from the attacking people, save some money. I don't know why, but it has saved me in the past being a little bit more conservative with my resources, because say one of my colonists gets a leg blown off, I've got to make sure they've got enough money to at least get a simple prosthetic leg, which most of the time I do. And then you then have to think about buying some medicine, if you don't have any left, to put your colonist to sleep in order to perform the operation. Shooty, mashooty, shoot. Mortars, yay! That is good for me! And now let's do electric smelting. Electric smelting! Once I can get my words out. And I'm also going to go ahead and make a mortar, but where can I really place this? I could create a mortar area within my base and just set it to be no roof. I think I might do that if I can. Zone, no roof region, add no roof region. Okay, because we're in a mountain, it won't let me do it. Damn it all, because I'm inside a mountain, it won't let me do it. Okay, that's fine. I guess I can just kind of wall off an area. I'll do it here. And then I'll create a door. And that can then be used as like a bunker. So much. No, I don't want to steal auto door. I'll just have a regular door. Like so. Now, mortars don't actually need power. Mortars need no kind of power. So, regardless... That fire's spreading. Regardless of where it is, you don't really need to lay any power cables, which is nice. I'm also going to set a no roof region. Oops. Boom. Add no roof region. Here, please. Thank you very much. And it still decided, I'm going to roof straight over the bit that I forgot to do no roof region. Okay, I don't particularly care. What are you doing? A group of angry alpha beavers. Okay, they will eat every single tree in sight. So let's set priority hunting on that. And they're quite easy to kill, so I should get a shitload of meat in order to save my colonists from starving, I guess. Doc is finishing his construction, which is good. Ush! Height! Why? Why now? Why now? Of all the times, when both of my hunters are outside and there's angry beavers outside. That was a brilliant animation, by the way, Angry Beavers. I used to watch that a lot on Nickelodeon. I think it was on Nickelodeon. Haven't seen it. Whoa, no. Angry Beavers and Cat Dog. Because why not? Okay, so those aren't too much of a worry right now. The alpha beavers. So let's get all of these guys inside. Alberto, you can stay as well. Now, I haven't got my mortars created right now, but if I did have my mortars, I'd be able to shell them from afar, more or less. So just for now, just so they don't go crazy, I'll lock the door, but I'll let them do their own thing, and I'm going to save just in case something goes terribly wrong. Hopefully it won't, because it's only a relatively small raid compared to what you can get in later game. And we've got plenty of turrets, so it should turn them into Swiss cheese in no time. He says. Well, he quirks in his boots. Come on, attack me already. Attack me, heathens. He's going to walk around, he's going to wander around. Okay, there we go. Righty then, it begins. The attack begins. So they've got mostly, as you can see, Aboriginal weapons. Those pilliars, which are kind of the long blow stick things, a bugger. They're more or less the snipers of the natives. Okie dokie. Are you off to bed now? I think you are, aren't you? You are, you're off to sleep. Okay. I will bust my cornice out if they need to, but I should be able to hold them off. Hopefully, if I kill a few of them, they'll flee. Which tends to happen. As you can see, Nat has already fleed. And they're going to start meleeing that turret, which isn't very nice, because if they kill that turret, it's going to kill them. Silly people. You're dead. There's one there. Is he dead? Yeah, he is. Okay. It is time! If I can... I might be able to try to avoid casualties. Because there's two there. But yeah, I'll take them outside if I unlock the door. There's that guy there, which has to run the gauntlet of the turrets again. Okay, so that guy's down. There's Val there, who's going to go down. Are you fleeing? No. You're actually making it easier for the turret to shoot you, you numpty. There we go, fleeing. There's that guy who's going to be dead, and I can take him captive. Okay, so we did quite well. We're not dead. I'll take this guy captive if I decide to select one of my guys. Capture. Is there any more that are not quite dead? No, the rest of them are more or less dead. Okay. So I need to make a few more graves. It was a grave decision for them to attack me. Just saying. Oh, bollocks. I hate doing that when you place a grave in the wrong place. Like, no! Okay, Lido, could he? So my colonists are free to do what they want now. Undraft. Now you're free to do what you want. You will go build the graves because I want you to. I'm also going to unforbid these meals. Now, the only pain in the ass of these meals now is the colonists, at the moment, will go find a more tasty food that's further away rather than one that's, like, close, which is fixed, hopefully, in the next alpha, but it's still a thing. At least in this one. Alpha 9, this is Alpha 8, we'll have that fixed. Hopefully, are you going to repair that? Doc, what are you doing? What are you doing, Doc? And you destroyed part of my wall, you numbskulls! Why? Why must you be so mean? And I did that wrong. I didn't mean to do a steel wall. I meant to do a wooden wall. The reason I do wooden walls is, yes, they go down easily, but they're cheaper to replace. You don't have to really worry, because there's that much wood on the map. That you can't really run out until you hit the winter. If you don't have a big wood supply in the winter, then it can screw you over slightly. Did Stumpy take some damage? No, that's Tony. Okay. Thoughts. What is your prison level? Holy shit. Okay. I will give them medicine. I will give them a friendly chat. But I'm not going to bother trying to recruit them, because that's basically impossible. The natives are always really hard to get onto your side because they are natives. They basically own the land and we are invaders. So it's kind of acceptable. Right, I'm going to get you, if I can select you, please, to actually start hauling this shit, please. Doc, you can... Oh, god damn it. I can tell them to strip them, but I can't tell them to do anything else. That guy was alive initially, but then he died a horrible, horrible, horrible death. Haul that, please. Yes, you can go ahead and heal her. That'll give me, if I release her, which I do plan to do, that'll give me another up point towards being allied to the natives, which is quite a good thing because late game, the natives tend to send larger and larger and larger groups. Not so much stronger groups, but they just overwhelm you with the amount of numbers that they have, which can be a pain in the ass, can lead to an early death within the colony. And Kate is there, hauling a beaver. Just casually, one-handed. I have noticed that the colonists seem extremely strong. Like, watch this. If you kind of... Oh, there's no place to store it. What? Oh, it's because the storing area is full. Okay, if I set another zone. I'll set a stockpile in here. I need to make a habit of stockpiling stuff inside because in the next alpha stuff that's left outside will become damaged over time. Why can't I haul this centipede? Why can't I not haul you? It is corpses. Oh, mechanoid corpses can be hauled, please. Doc, you really could. Doc is not a hauler. God damn it. God damn you, Doc. You're so useless. Maybe. Not quite. You've actually done quite a lot of work compared to what some of the buggers have done. So you're going to haul you the beaver and cut it up, slice it up. So I'm just wondering what I should turn this area into. What have I researched that I haven't actually built yet? Production. Smithing bench. Nothing really. What did I research? Can't remember now. I suppose it doesn't really matter at the moment. What did I finish researching? Researched. Oh, mortars. Ah, that's what I forgot to build. I forgot to build a few mortars. Okay. So if I go to security, and I always do a steel mortar. They are the explosive type. And don't set fire to things, because if they're firing around my wooden base, you don't really want to have fire, because that can cause terrible, terrible, terrible consequences, and that's not very nice to have. Once you're done sleeping, I'd really like you to haul the dead people, because you will get negative thoughts and may go crazy. Cater, you're gonna get up early and you're gonna haul. No, I don't want you to. Are you not even a hauler? Yes, you are, but why won't you haul? Oh, okay. Because it's because I drafted her. God damn it. Haul the digger. Now, there's some good weapons here, but they're not really. Something that could match up to a mechanoid, because the mechanoids are dicks, to put it frankly. But there again, they are okay, so I'll probably build some weapon storage. I've still got a bit of a cold, by the way, you may have noticed. It's not as bad as it was, but it does occasionally tickle the back of my throat, which isn't very fun. But then again, just saw what's wrong with it. Okie dokie. Some weapon storage in here. Now you'll find, once you've played for a while, you'll just have... Why do I want a desiccated squirrel that's 25 days old? Why? Can I get... I'm just okay. You're just gonna all right. You're just gonna take a desiccated squirrel in. They are like cats. Then they find something, they bring it in, and hey, have a gift. But I don't want your gift. I don't care. I will leave it on you in your front room. I don't own a cat, by the way. But that's what I get. I own dogs. Doggies. Okay, oh, there's some more stuff and things here. So let's mine out that. Any more stuff and things that I missed? I tend to do that. Like, on the initial inspection, I missed stuff. And I come back later and it's just there. It's as if it's not there at first, but then the game is, hey, this guy needs some more stuff. Let's give him some more stuff. How are you doing? Are you ready to be released yet? Alright, so we've got someone who's good at bandaging. And usually at first I have someone who's shite at bandaging and then they improve through time, but looks like we've got someone who's decent at bandaging. I'll wait until she's completely healed and I'll let her walk off the map, because sometimes if you release them too early they wander too much and then die. Okay, you can bury Val. What are your thoughts? By the way, I keep forgetting to disable the dev options. I don't actually use them, but I just further forget, hence why I've got these little tabs up here, which are like the debug log with nothing in it. Scotty, loading file from Scotty with mods Core. And Core is the main game. This is a completely unmodded version of the game. There is plenty and loads of mods out there that occasionally get added to the game. Like, I remember that initially the Steel Royal Bed was a mod that could be enabled and disabled, and then it was basically pulled in. And in the next alpha, there's going to be some more gun art implemented. And I just kicked something underneath my desk. That wasn't very smart of me. Okie dokie, so we've got the mortars up. No, the mortars have not been constructed yet. What are you actually building? Oh, you're building what I told you to build, for once. But then again, you're not building the sudden mortars, which I told you to build. You're just gonna do exactly what you want. Okay, so I can now release this person. If I go onto prisoner and then release, they are free to go. And they will wander off the map. Now, if you could please haul the meat before it goes off, that would be very nice. Just meat casually on the bed, why not? I will allow you to sleep once you have hauled all of the meat. There we are. Now there's plenty of pelts on the floor, but that'll be used later. I haven't created a mission, have I? No, I haven't. Yeah, I have. I'm gonna set some tailor works off. I've got a few parkas, but then again, might be worth making a jacket or two, because on my kind of map, it won't actually get that cold. And you're eating that off the floor, seriously. I guess it's better than eating it with all the rubble. Maybe there's a barney in there. I don't know. Barney rubble. ignore me. Going slightly crazy. Okay, let's fast forward. What is that? An eclipse has begun. Hopefully my power should be able to hold out for at least a day. I've got plenty of power right now. It will gradually reduce, but I don't have much that's power dependent. I can always shut down the turrets if I need to. But then again, I'm not overly dependent on the sun, because I've got this hooked up, and very soon I'll have this one hooked up, the geothermal power generators. two construction materials missing. Doc, can you like cut down the tree so I don't have two construction materials missing? Thank you. So they're going to start constructing the mortars, which is very, very good for me. And I really wish you could haul the potatoes. I really, really wish you could haul the potatoes. Rather than just kind of leaving them outside, you lazy bugger. Haul all of the potatoes. Or you can just go and get more potatoes. That works fine. God damn you and your potatoes. Potato. 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 Righty. Stumpy, get all of the potatoes. There we go. So they're going to plant yet more potatoes. I'm soon going to be overwhelmed with potato. I can't stop saying potato. Don't know why. But there we go. Construction materials missing. Oh god, I need some more iron. Oh, okay. Did I tell them to mine some more out? I think I did, but there's not. Any more iron? There's some down there. Compact steel. But they haven't mined it out yet. I need that uranium, why not? And a desiccated wild boar. Okay, so they're finishing mining inside, which is good. I'll put some heating in there shortly, because it's only 7 degrees indoors. You just tented a cluster of pods. Ooh. All grave fruits, that's nice. Oh shit, a roof has collapsed. The roof is starting to collapse because this area is too large. Oh no. Let's quickly make that and then make a wooden door just to save my cornice from being horribly, horribly smushed into pieces. Yay, there we go. I should save it now. It was in the middle there and then it automatically reconstructed itself, which was good for me. What is that? Another eclipse? Oh no, the eclipse has ended. I was like, what? How many eclipses? Okay, so they're gonna go ahead and mine that out. It's now -4, and that's at night. So we need to look into getting some more heating in. Currently 1 degrees on the inside. So if we go ahead and place a heater here, and I've got a heater there. I place a heater here. Now, it would be really good if I could vent the heat in here from the 111 degree thermal generator into here, but at the moment the distance is too far, it wouldn't really work. But it's a good thing to think about in the future. And I need to hopefully get some hold of some parkas soon. Because some parkas will basically save my colonists from freezing to death when they go outside. Oh, really? Okay. I think on that note, I'm going to stop recording here. And hopefully, I will be able to survive that mechanoid attack. As usual, I'll include a link in the description for you guys to give it a try for yourself. But that's all for me for now. See ya.